When the frail-hearted fat man and I rendezvous at the community center each morning, there are already four women there walking around the track. They look like they're in their mid-70s. They stride briskly in a rightward circle on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, and left on Tuesdays and Thursdays. I watch them from the back of a machine that approximates cross-country skiing, an activity I did as a boy in snow with grace and fun, and now ponderously as a grim old man. One thing I find remarkable about these women is how well-groomed and put together they are. There isn't a hair out of place among them. Each is crowned by a sensible but attractive do, and their clothes are equally sensible and attractive and maybe expensive. By contrast, I've just rolled out of bed, tossed on yesterday's carpenter pants, and wear a ball cap to cover the gray mess that convenes on the top of my face every day. They nod when I first arrive, but otherwise pay me no attention, and there is no reason why they should. I imagine that they are all widows, and I suspect that they've paid their dues. They've spent years waiting for their men to grow up, and then later, hours and hours in waiting rooms to hear the verdicts of cardiologists or proctologists or urologists about the futures of these same men. They stride around and around the track, merge into pairs and talk softly. I pick up fragments of conversation, a pleasant humming burble, until it is drowned out by a newly arrived exerciser who turns on the television to hear the morning news. It is the same news as yesterday and the day before, but he is transfixed and riveted to the spot. He treadmills about 1/10 of a mile an hour. Mrs. Clinton appears on the screen. She is somewhere in the Middle East, confabbing with a very important man. She looks tired. And the truth of the matter is that she's looked tired for the last 20 years. And why shouldn't she? She made a president out of a genial and brilliant sociopath who would otherwise have ended up owning the largest Chevy dealership in Hot Springs or serving time in a minimum security federal prison. It had to be exhausting. The news on the television turns to some men who want to regulate uteruses and don't want to regulate coal mines. The women on the community center track go round and round. They've been at it for more than 30 minutes now and have become quite animated. They joke and laugh and are oblivious to the two old fat men sweating on the sidelines, and to the boys on the TV who think they know the score. That's all the news from Berryville this week. We'll see you next week.
Psst! Hey you! Little girl! Come here!
Excuse me? Come here? In what world would I, an intelligent, fully evolved woman of the world, respond to "come here" from a vile little man wearing a gold neck chain?
Hey, no offense, Dolly. I'm a legit guy. Here, take my card.
Salmonella. National spokesman for synthetically produced vegetable matter. Spavin. What in the world is synthetically produced vegetable matter?
What's synthetically produced vegetable matter? Young lady, spavin is all of them great greens and reds and yellow colored triangle thingies piled up in the produce aisles. They're perfect. Round is round, and tubes are fantastically tubular. They're great.
Are you talking about tomatoes and zucchini? They won't be at our farmers' markets for at least another week, maybe 10 days. No, thank you, Mr. Manila. I believe in seasonal eating, so I'll wait a little bit.
Wait? Are you nuts? Spavin means you can have what you want when you want it. Wait! Waiting is for losers, little girl.
Pardon me, but I've learned that good things come to those who wait. If I simply and mindlessly bought spavin instead of eating seasonally, I would miss the feeling of anticipation for next week's Arkansas Traveler tomatoes, the desire and the longing for local melons and apples. Love, Mr. Manila. Real love always involves waiting and hoping. So no, no thanks to your synthetically produced vegetable matter. I want the real thing. I want fresh, local, and truthful food.
Oh, you're a rotten kid.
No, Mr. Manila. I'm a healthy, radiant, attractive, and fully alive young woman because I eat real food produced by my friends and neighbors. So no spavin for me.
Here's some news of interest to photographers among our listening audience. Carroll County Fresh announces its first annual photography contest. We're using this contest as a way to publicize our farms and farmers and to celebrate our way of life here in the Ozark Mountains of Arkansas. Carroll County Fresh invites professional and amateur photographers to submit photographs in three categories. There's still life photographs of growing edible plants and or of raw and prepared foods. So if you happen to find yourself in a field or a garden and there's a beautiful tomato plant or an eggplant growing there, take a picture of it and send it in. Or if you happen to stop by a farmer's market and buy a basket of apples and go home and bake a pie, well, bake that pie, but take a picture of the finished product and send that in as well. Another category is portraits, candid or staged, of farmers or farm families who live and work in the Ozarks. Finally, the third category is landscapes. And these are photographs of farmland, buildings, livestock, machinery, and so on, set in the Ozarks, of course. Landscapes can include market gardens, farmers markets, and other farm-related scenery. Photographs should be taken between now, March 3rd, and October 15th, 2012, within 75 miles of Eureka Springs, Arkansas. There are some money prizes. The grand prize, best of show, gets $100. First place in each category, $50. Second place in each category, $35. And third place, $25. We also have an honorable mention category. These photographs remain the property of the photographer, but Carroll County Fresh has the rights to use pictures for its calendars and note cards and so on. There will be a gallery showing of these photographs in Eureka Springs. We will invite the photographers to that opening along with the general public and present the checks there, drink some wine, eat some cheese, and have a good time. I should let you know that you can get more information about this contest, including how to submit them, at the Carroll County Fresh web site, which is carrollcountyfresh.org. That's one word, carrollcountyfresh.org. So take some pictures and help us celebrate the beautiful world we live in. That's our show for the week. We hope you've enjoyed it. Next week, our guest will be Jerry Landrum of the Eco Green Center Jerry takes us on a tour of his interesting and sustainable and appropriate technology center here in Eureka Springs. Richard Pillay joins me for the interview. The Ozark Harvest Radio Hour is a production of Carroll County Fresh, who thank writer and producer Dan Croats, Dr. Sharon Sloan, Director of Technology, Dr. Fred Mayer, Music Director, Richard Pillay, reporter and editorialist, Mary Hayat, National Spokesperson for Living Better Without Chemistry. We thank the Board of Directors of Carroll County Fresh, Jane Pillay, President Andrew Scherwin, Vice President John Toombs, Treasurer, and Reverend Judy Turner, Secretary. We thank Fiacre, Patron Saint of Gardens, and Program Theologian. And our listeners, the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour is organic radio, not always perfect, not always pretty, but always fresh, local, and honest. Until next week, go out and grow something.